So, yesterday I created this topography using the new point cloud to topography tool by Environment for Revit. Then I made this awesome sequence and I wanted to share the gospel with you. So let's start a new project. Now I'm going to import a point cloud, which was sent to us by our Czech partners, Add-on. It's warning me that it's a large file with more than 30,000 points. Undesirable graphic behaviors is a nice way of saying that my computer might die. All right, yes. Now, as you can see, it's a large area of this river run. It's actually the junction of two main rivers in Europe, the Berlina and the Elbe River. The Elbe is huge, it goes through Berlin and Dresden. Now, Add-on's client, and I hope I'm going to pronounce it right, it's Povodí Ukše. They're doing water management and treatment for this basin. All right, so let's select the point cloud, go to the Environment tab, and select the brand new point cloud to topography tool. Now, if you don't need the whole thing, you can adjust the area of the topography with these arrows just like a normal section box. You can also draw a specific region here. I'm just going to stick with the whole thing. Also, if you want to be able to work with more manageable size toposolids, I would recommend adjusting the number of elevation points here. Then Environment will break the surface into a few segments, so it's easier to edit. I'm actually looking forward to testing this thing, so I'm going to extend the limit to 50,000 elevation points. Don't try this at home. All right, I only have sea level in my project and one type of toposolid, so I guess I will stick to those and okay. Now, I am going to fast forward my recording, but you can see here exactly how many minutes the process took. So, one, two, three, four on the dot. And there you have it. There are a lot of details, so it's hard to see. Let me add a section box and zoom in a little. You can really see how Environment ignored everything but the terrain. It's beautifully done. Now, let's recreate the sequence that I showed you at the beginning. So, I'm going to add a selection view in order to reduce the noise of the point cloud. Much better, but I can reduce the depth a bit more. Let's set the far clip offset to 50 meters. Nice. Now I'm going to arrange the windows and let's look at the result. This is amazing. The only thing I'm doing right now is pressing the left key on my keyboard. You can see that the section line moves and I'm cutting through the topography. It's so nice. Obviously, there might be small hiccups here and there, but all in all, the new topography is stunning and follows the terrain beautifully while ignoring the bridges, plants, and buildings. And that's it. All right. Not bad for 4 minutes of work. Bye.